Hey guys, welcome to the channel. Today we'll take you through programming a Centurion Nova code hopping one button, two button or four button remote onto a Nova Helix single channel receiver. Let's get into it. As with any receiver, buying it out of the box new, you would want to reset it. So we'll take you through the reset process real quick. Make sure your device is powered on. Place the jumper onto J2. The LED will start flashing. You wait for the LED to go solid. During that solid light, you have to remove the jumper and the device is reset. Once the device is reset, the first remote programmed either via one of two methods will be a master remote. The first method I'm going to show you is the pin method. So you put your jumper back onto center pin in J1, press and hold the remote button you want to program, 3 seconds minimum. When you let go, receiver will confirm. You remove your jumper. You have learnt your first master remote. The second method of programming a master or learning a master remote is as follows. After the receiver has been defaulted, the first remote you press and hold for more than 3 seconds. Receiver confirm. This is now your master remote. Your master remote can then be used to program more master remotes without using the jumper programming method. I'll take you through that quick. You press and hold on your master button 10 to 20 seconds. The receiver will confirm by giving you a long beep. It's in master learning. The next master remote you're gonna press and hold more than 3 seconds. The receiver has confirmed. If you have more master remotes, this is when you program it in, you have to wait for the receiver to exit master learning mode if you are finished programming your master remotes. Let's test it out. So now this remote can also go into master mode and learn more masters. If you just want to learn a remote, a normal user can use the jumper method, which is middle pin, J1, press and hold your remote button, 3 seconds or more, you let go, receiver confirms, button has been learned. Once you have programmed more than one master remote and you found that the second or third master remote should be a standard user, you can demaster the remote. I'll take you through the process. You'll press and hold your master button on the remote that should stay a master. You'll press and hold it between 20 and 30 seconds. Double long beep. So you'll press and hold the button you want to make a non-master for 3 seconds or more. The receiver confirmed that it's been demastered. You wait for the receiver to exit demaster mode. Check your remote, it's still working, but it's unable to learn more remotes. The following procedure is to delete a remote off the system completely. So that would be for demastered remotes or normal learned-in remotes. So you'll press and hold 20 to 30 seconds, double long beep. So you press and hold the button for 10 seconds. Receiver's confirmed, delete. Wait for it to exit demaster mode. remote. The remote is no longer on the system. If you want to change the receiver from a pulse to a latch mode, you have to power down the receiver. You have to place a jumper on middle pin in J2. And you will need a master remote for this. Power on the device. Press and hold the master remote for 3 seconds or more. You'll see the LED is flashing. 1 pulse, 2 pulses, 3 pulses and 4 pulses. The latch function is on 2 pulses. You'll wait for it to pulse twice and remove the jumper. It will now confirm your setting. Setting is saved. 1 press, latch on. 1 press latch off, 1 press latch on, 1 press latch off. As always guys, Savil here, thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to the channel. Go ahead and check out the other videos on the channel. Leave a comment below, leave a comment on future videos you'd like to see. And I'll catch you next time.